comes in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. We are here to pay our respects to Jeanette and to worship our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Eternal God, we bless you for the great company of all those who have kept the faith, finished the race, and who now rest from their labor. We praise you for those dear to us whom we name in our hearts before you. Especially we thank you for Jeanette, whom you have now received into your presence. Help us to believe where we have not seen, trusting you to lead us through our years. Bring us at last with all your saints into the joy of your home, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us turn to our hymn books and sing How Great Thou Art. And tell him out of practice, I did not write down the hymn numbers for myself. You have it?
615.
615. 625. 625.
Thank you.
September 12, 1934, in Austin, Minnesota. She was baptized and confirmed at St. Olaf Lutheran Church in Austin. She graduated from Austin High School in 1952. Jeanette received her nursing training at Northwestern Hospital from September 1952 to 1955. She moved to Redwood Falls in October 1955 and worked at the Redwood Falls Hospital. On May 6, 1956, Jeanette married Floyd Cotful. Together they moved to a farm near Vesta where they lived until 1986. She worked as an office nurse for Dr. Hudick in Echo. When they left the farm, they moved into the town of Vesta, where she was a member of the local ladies' extension group. Jeanette was a member of the Redwood Falls and Vesta Presbyterian churches, where she served as a deacon. She was a member of the Post Office Auxiliary and was Auxiliary Member of the Year in 1992. In 2011, Jeanette moved to Marshall, where she has resided since. Jeanette enjoyed attending Bible studies and her grandchildren's activities, especially football and basketball games. She crocheted and made neckties. To relax, she would play cards, cribbage, and Scrabble. She loved to read, and after her vision was failing, she would listen to autobiographies. Jeanette was able to take a trip to Norway with family. Jeanette passed away Friday, February 17, 2023, surrounded by family at Prairie Home Hospice in Marshall at the age of 88. Jeanette is survived by her children, Chris and wife Lisa Cotful of Crosslake, Dan and wife Mary Lynn Cotful of Rochester, and Katie and husband Dean Busak of Vesta. Grandchildren, Jason and wife Anna Busak, Andrew Cotful, Sarah Jane Cotful, and Brian and wife Leah Busak. Great-grandchildren, Emmanuel Busak, Gabe and Micah Flynn, and Bennett Cotful. Addison Hughes and Macy and Britta Busak, siblings Sonia and husband Robert Brandt of Shakopee, and Sharon Schumacher of Sioux Falls, and many other relatives and friends. She was preceded in death by her parents, husband Floyd, and an infant brother Charles. Blessed be her memory. Now let us turn to the hymn 488, I Was There to Hear Your Morning Cry. of all, true wisdom, calm the troubled waters of our hearts, and still all other voices but your own, that we may hear and obey what you tell us in your word, through the power of your Spirit. Amen. The first scripture passage I would like to share with you is Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I would also like to share with you from the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, verses 1 through 8. Everything on earth has its own time and its own season. There's a time for birth and death, planting and reaping, for killing and healing, destroying and building, for crying and laughing, weeping and dancing, for throwing stones and gathering stones, embracing and parting. There is a time for finding and losing, keeping and giving, for tearing and sowing, listening and speaking. There is also a time for love and hate, for war and peace. The next passage I would like to share with you comes from the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 4, verse 16, through chapter 5, verse 1. We never give up. Our bodies are gradually dying, but we ourselves are made stronger each day. These little troubles are getting us ready for an eternal glory that will make all our troubles seem like nothing. Things that are seen don't last forever, but things that are not seen are eternal. This is why we keep our minds on the things that cannot be seen. Our bodies are like tents, and we live here on earth. But when these tents are destroyed, we know that God will give each of us a place to live. These homes will not be buildings someone has made, but they are in heaven and will last forever. The final passage I would like to share with you comes from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verses 1 through 6. Jesus said to his disciples, "Don't be worried. Have faith in God and have faith in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. I wouldn't tell you this unless it was true. I am going there to prepare a place for each of you. After I have done this, I will come back and take you with me, and we will be together. You know the way to where I'm going." Thomas said, "Lord, we don't even know where you are going. How can we know the way?" "I am the way, the truth, and the life," Jesus answered. "Without me, no one can go to the Father." Psalm 23 reminds us that God is here leading us and protecting us all the days of our lives. We are never alone, and God will never abandon us. Our Ecclesiastes passage reminds us there is a time to be born and a time to die. Let us take a brief look back at Jeanette's life and then talk about where she is today. Whenever I had the opportunity to spend time with Jeanette, I knew a couple things would happen. We would laugh. We would pray for all of her concerns, and she often prayed for me. And I would leave her place thinking, the world is a better place because of her. She loved to tell the story of how she met her future husband when her good friend and fellow nursing student, Joyce, brought her home to Vesta for the weekend, and she met Joyce's brother Floyd, who became the love of her life. Joyce was not only her sister-in-law, but a lifelong friend. They spoke on the phone daily until Joyce's death this past summer. After Floyd died 11 years ago, Jeanette was ready to go to her heavenly home too. It was not a goal of hers to be old or frail. She would ask me why God was keeping her around, and I would say, God isn't finished with you yet. She couldn't figure out why, but I said, maybe God is using you to touch the hearts of others. I think she touched many hearts with her kindness, her faith, her genuine interest in other people, and her sense of humor. She was pretty good at throwing out zingers, but they were never unkind or mean. Jeanette says she was not your typical farmer's wife. We joked that Floyd and she were like Eddie Albert and Ava Gabor on Green Acres. Jeanette was an excellent cook, but she did not care to cook. She was a night owl, so the family was on their own for breakfast. Jeanette did freeze enough sweet corn each year to last all year long. She also canned pickles for many years. She would wash the cucumbers in an old wringer washer with towels to get the dirt off. She enjoyed her flower garden in the backyard, which Floyd landscaped for her. Jeanette loved her family deeply. She left a note for them that she wrote a while ago. To my family, you will never know how much I love each of you. I'm not very good at putting into words the way I feel. And whenever I try to put it into words, I get weepy. Not that I'm sad. I'm not. But for some reason, I just cry easily. To Jason, Brian, Andrew, and Sarah, what joy you've given me. Jeanette would light up when she talked about her family, especially her grandchildren and great-grandchildren. Katie said her grandchildren could do no wrong in her eyes. Recently, I think I heard the most about her great-grandson, Manny, who lived in the same town and saw his great-grandmother often. Jeanette taught him to sing Baba Black Sheep. As a mother, Jeanette was tough but fair. Dan remembered that as a child, she had a miniature doghouse above the kitchen sink with three dogs representing each of the children. When someone did something she didn't approve of, she put the dog in the doghouse. Sometimes they knew why, sometimes they didn't. Before the kids went to an activity like roller skating, Jeanette would say they couldn't go unless their bedroom passed the white glove test. Jeanette was an avid reader and often took her children to the Redwood Falls Library. Katie recalls if she wanted to go to a movie, she had to read the book first. Dan said that rule didn't apply to him because most of the movies he went to had no book first. With Jeanette's nursing background, she was pretty tolerant of bumps, scrapes, and accidents, and did not rush to take her kids to the emergency room. Floyd did step in a few times and say, we are going to the hospital. Once when Katie had a painful nose, which turned out to be broken, and once again when Dan had a sore foot, and it turned out to be broken. The kids were very thankful their father was there. Jeanette and Floyd attended all their kids' and grandkids' sporting events over the years. They would drive wherever they needed to go. Chris said his mother always supported him in what he chose to do. Dan said his mother was my rock, the place I could always go for a friendly ear, a calm voice, and words of wisdom. Jeanette inspired her kids to be kind and honest, to be thoughtful of others, to go to church, to be respectful and considerate. Jeanette's family gave me a list of her favorite Bible passages, and they all deal with how to treat other people, such as Colossians chapter 3, verse 13. Put up with each other and forgive anyone who does you wrong. just as Christ has forgiven you. In Proverbs chapter 10, verse 19, you will say the wrong thing if you talk too much. So be sensible and watch what you say. She also treasured extravagant forgiveness stories in the Bible, as when Joseph forgave his brothers after they sold him as a slave. Esau forgiving Jacob after Jacob deceived him. And David forgiving Saul, who was trying to kill him. Jeanette loved Bible studies and joined everyone that she could. Jeanette was a lifelong learner. When her eyesight gave out, she started listening to the long biographies of the presidents in chronological order. She learned in detail about the first six presidents. Jeanette loved listening to music. My son Matthew visited Jeanette with me shortly before she moved from Boulder Estates. She asked Matthew, "Who is your favorite singer?" Which was the rap artist Post Malone. Matthew was kind of afraid to tell her that. But Jeanette listened to the rap singer music after we left. She called me later and reported that she didn't care much for the music. But she took an interest in what a teenage boy listens to, which was one of her superpowers. When Jeanette zoomed in on you, you felt like you were the only person in the world. She enjoyed piano music and encouraged people that knew how to play the piano to keep up on their skills. She really looked forward to our choir singing each week, especially the Christmas cantata. After she moved to Marshall and would come back to Redwood to visit, her first question would be, "Is the choir singing?" Jeanette enjoyed playing Scrabble, cribbage, and other card games, and she played to win. She took pleasure in collecting clowns because they made her happy, long before all the scary clown horror movies came to fruition. In earlier days, she did lots of crocheting and sewing. Purple was her favorite color. She was quite savvy at making cards on her computer for all occasions until her eyesight diminished. She enjoyed watching Jeopardy and Dancing with the Stars on television. She loved watching musicals, and some of her favorites were the Sound of Music, White Christmas, and Fiddler on the Roof. Traveling was another passion of hers, from going to Norway, Hawaii, New York, and Arizona, among other places. It was fun for her to travel to all the Postmaster meetings with Floyd, which were held all over the country. She took pleasure in gatherings of family or friends. For years, relatives from both sides of the family would meet at a hotel for a weekend as a Christmas gathering. She treasured those weekends. Jeanette was an avid, fast-paced walker. When they lived in the country, she would walk over to visit neighbors, even a mile or two away. When she lived at Boulder Estates, she would walk the hallways and stairways. Once, when I was visiting, she asked if I could take her to Menards. She went racing through the aisles so quickly that I thought she should have a bell or a horn so she didn't run over people. Jeanette loved talking to her family on the phone. If her kids waited 3 weeks to call her, that was too long. 2 weeks was okay. Once a week was perfect. One year for Christmas, she asked that her kids call each week, and she kept track of it. As her health worsened, her kids would call her every couple of days. Jeanette was looking forward to heaven and being able to see again. She had a strong faith in God. She wrote in a note to her family that death is not extinguishing the light. It is putting out the lamp because the dawn is coming. Jeanette also wrote, "To live in the hearts we leave behind is not to die. There are many special people who in a corner of my heart lie. So maybe, if it's not much trouble, when we must part, you could just tuck me in the corner of your heart. Our Corinthians passage reminds us that when our earthly tent wears out, we will be given a permanent structure made by the hands of God. Jesus said that when it is our time, he himself will come and lead us to heaven, to a place God has prepared for us. When Jesus was hanging on the cross, he told the repentant thief, "Today you will be with me in paradise." Paradise is a place with no diseases, no weaknesses, no problems. It is a perfect place. Jeanette has been called to her eternal home. I believe she is having the opportunity to be reunited with all those loved ones that went before her. Her husband Floyd, her parents, her grandparents, her sister-in-law Joyce, her brother Charles, and all the many others. Someday we all will be reunited because of our own faith in Jesus Christ. I ask you to continue to keep Katie, Dan, and Chris and their families in your prayers. Keep checking on them in the future. So often we just give people a week to grieve, but we know the process takes a long time. Give them a call or send them a card in the coming months and years. Let them know that you are thinking of them. Let us give thanks to God for sharing Jeanette with us for a while. Let us give thanks to God for the gift of eternal life. Let us give thanks to God for the gift of Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you. Let us pray. O God, before whom generations arise and pass away, we praise you for all your servants who, having lived this life in faith, now live eternally with you. Especially we thank you for your servant Jeanette, whose baptism is now complete in death. We praise you for the gift of her life, for all in her that was good and kind and faithful, for the grace you gave her that kindled in her the love of your dear name. We thank you for all the lives she enriched as a daughter, a sister, a wife, a mother, a grandmother, a great-grandmother, an aunt, a friend, a neighbor, a Christian. We thank you that her death has passed and her pain has ended, that she now has entered the joy you have prepared. Now let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Our next hymn is Softly and Tenderly, Jesus is Calling. 418, thank you, baby. We commend Jeanette to your merciful care and the faith of Christ our Lord, who died and rose again to save us, and who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Following this worship service, you are welcome to go to the church dining room for a time of food and fellowship. Why don't we say a prayer for that meal right now? Awesome God, we thank you for this opportunity to come and pay our respects to Jeanette. We ask that you bless our time together as we share stories and memories about her. Please bless this food that we are about to eat. May it give us the strength we need to do the work you have called us to do. And all these things we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Please stand now to receive the benediction. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Our closing hymn for today is Amazing Grace.
649.
649.